All right, girlfriend, we ready? See you later, okay.
What up, peeps? Good morning. It has been a day the past, I don't even know how many hours, 12, 16 hours. It's been a situation. So I have gotten the kids off, or I got CJ off on the bus, and now I'm getting ready to take Reagan to school so that I can go back to the hospital where baby is. I know, long story, we'll talk about it. So let's see, yesterday babe and I were working at the co-working space, and towards the end of the day he was getting ready to leave and go get Reagan. He had went and picked up Chad, came back, so he was getting ready to go get Reagan because we were almost finishing up. And he says that he was feeling kind of like shortness of breath, like he couldn't catch his breath. I don't remember if he said a little bit of chest pain, I think, but it was mostly like shortness of breath. And then he felt a couple shooting pains in his shoulder. So he like walked to the car, and then Siege had to go to the bathroom, so they walked back in, then back to the car, and he sat there and he was just like, something just didn't feel right. So he didn't feel comfortable driving. So he called me and he was like, yeah, something's not right. So we went to the ER and, they admitted him fairly quickly. And then we found out that kids couldn't be in the hospital. They couldn't even be in the waiting room. So I called mom. Mom came and got the kids. She took them to her house and I stayed with babe all night. They admitted him to the hospital, but they didn't take him to a regular room. Like, they kept him in the ER. So I was glad because I was able to spend the night, because, like, you know, technically in the hospital they have like visiting hours and they're not allowing adult patients to have, you know, anybody spend the night. So I was glad they got to stay in the ER. So I left at 5:30 this morning so that I could get up, get Siege and Ray and get him on the bus and all that stuff. So now it's 8:30 and I'm just praying that he's still asleep. I haven't heard from him yet. So they did all the testing and his cardiac enzymes were a bit elevated. So they wanted to keep him overnight so that they could do a stress test and an echocardiogram this morning. So I was like, on E, the light came on the way home from mom's house. I was like, I gotta stop and give me some gas. So prayerfully, I will get there before he even wakes up, and especially before they do the echo. So yeah, that's what's happening. It's been a long 16 hours, probably 16 plus right now. On another note, why is gas so expensive? Why? I will never get over it. I just remember the days when gas was like 99 cents. So I got here, y'all. And I got to the room and he wasn't there. I was like, hold on now.
Yeah.
So they brought him up to a room and just finished your
echocardiogram.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
How are you feeling, love?
Just waiting for a clean bill of health.
Yeah.
Waiting to hear that it's all good.
Yeah.
So I can train again.
Are you worried about his training?
Well, I'm worried about, you know, being healthy for my kids first, and you, and then training.
And then training, yeah. Yes, I know. We know you've been training and training and training, and the Ironman is the goal. But I told him his health is more important, so.
Yeah, it is. No, it
take
is.
It easy if you have to.
Well, the good thing about
the doctor's orders.
The good thing about it is my triathlon coach is an ER doctor.
Yeah.
So.
That helps.
He's not gonna, I filled him in, he's not gonna let me do anything, you know, he won't let me do anything if, like, he doesn't come back.
With a clean bill of health. Right? Yeah, exactly.
So, he said, but if it comes back good, that, you know, you can start training right away and, you know, cause. Yeah, so that's a good thing. That's a good thing.
It's all out.
Oh, my bad. That's a good thing to know, to have. You know?
Yeah, yeah.
He has knowledge in this, you know. But, yeah, so just.
That's a blessing. I mean, because how many, like.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Like, how many triathlon coaches, you know, for him to be an ER doctor, that's crazy.
It's one of the reasons I really liked picking him, because I was like, okay, you're not only good at triathlon, but you're also a doctor.
Right, so you know how the body works.
Like, yeah, you know
he's how not going to have
works.
You overdoing it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So, Yeah, so I'm just trying not to be anxious, you know. Like, that's been the whole goal, is just not be anxious.
Yeah.
So.
Did you see the other doctor again? Did she come back in? No. We had a really nice doctor last night. Dr. D. She was so awesome. Like, her bedside manner was... She was so calm, and she was joking with Chad, and just, you know what I'm saying? Like, we were talking about how so many things are in your mind, and, like, people, like, it's, they work themselves up. So, yeah, she was just talking about all that and talking about how people are so quick to claim genetics. Well, this runs in my family, this runs in my family, but also they neglect looking at their lifestyle. Like, what are the choices that you're making that's contributing to that? Because genetics is one thing, yes, some things run in the family, but your lifestyle trumps that. So
yeah.
I
also just learned really something from the echocardiogram.
Oh, the nurse that was just in here,
what do you call that person?
I don't know.
Echocardiologist?
Echocardiologist?
I'm making up words here.
Yeah, I don't know.
She's the nurse that did the echocardiogram.
Yeah.
And so she... So echocardiogram, in case you don't know, is like an ultrasound of the heart. So, and so she said that they did like a test, a bubble test, where they put aggravated saline, like they moved the saline back and forth between two syringes, and then they pushed it into my IV, and then they look at it to see if like some of it trickles into the other side
of the heart,
I guess, into the left side. And so there was a little bit that did. So she said that, so I learned, you know, whether it's accurate or not, the doctor, I'm sure, will tell us, but that 25% of people have, like, a hole in their heart, like, have holes in their heart. And so, but, like, it's not, like, an issue, I guess. So it was interesting to...
Yeah, I didn't know that.
So I had, like, because some of it came from the right side to the left side a little bit. So I guess meaning...
Yeah.
There's some leakage. I don't know.
Yeah, she said, I mean, she said that. She was like, I'm just a nurse. Like, you know, as in the doctor is going to tell you what the results are. Because I think we were like, well, what does that, you know, what does that mean?
Yeah.
So, you know, the doctor's going to come in and tell us all that good stuff.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. I'm hungry at this point.
Yeah, I was just going to ask you, can you eat?
No, she said that right now. Can't have nothing but some sips of water.
Oh, that sucks. Because I thought about that too. I was like, oh, I wonder if I should bring him coffee. But then I was like, he probably can't have nothing.
Yeah, not yet.
Yeah.
Best believe, as soon as we leave, though.
We're getting something, honey.
Yes,
okay. Start it.
But yeah, so, you know, God is good.
God is good. The greatest thing about all of this is that you're here. You're okay, and you came in. Like, I think that's the biggest lesson.
Mm-hmm.
You felt like something wasn't right, and you came in. You didn't just brush it off.
Yeah.
So,
I almost did, but it just felt kind of weird. So I was like, let me just call Gabrielle and tell her. Because I was getting a little bit lightheaded. And I was like, well, I shouldn't drive. I was like, well, if I shouldn't drive, I probably should call Gabrielle. Mm-hmm. She was just, like, inside the building still.
Yeah.
So.
I'll tell them we were at the co-working space, so.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
What's going on?
We'll keep you posted.
Look who it is! How was your day?
What? Are you gonna look up and say hello?
Hi.
Best part of your day?
Music. I'm at reading. No library.
Wait, what? Which one?
Library.
Did you turn in your book?
What would you mean, like ambulant?
Well, your library book. Did you have to turn it in and get a new one?
Yeah. I turned in both of my books.
Did you? Well, what'd you get?
I got Fuzzy.
Okay.
And what was the other book called?
Fuzzy. Is that about a bear?
No.
Oh.
It's about a robot at school.
Oh.
It's called Fuzzy because Fuzzy's ridden on his sweater. Or I don't know what the title is.
Oh. That's just what's on his sweater.
There's one more. What was it again?
Can't remember. can't remember.
Oh, Mercy Watson.
Mercy Watson?
Yes.
Hmm. Is that like a series?
Yeah, we read it in second grade.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So we're hanging out. Oh, did you guys ever finish typing your story?
I finished typing 2 mysteries.
Oh, look at you.
I'm at 1.
Are you getting quicker?
Yeah, kind of. It's hard.
Yeah.
Because I don't have a keyboard.
But you can bring a keyboard?
Yes, we can bring a keyboard.
Do other kids have keyboards?
Yes. We should look on Amazon for like $5 or $10. Because Nash got his like 5 and it works perfectly on Amazon.
Is it just for an iPad?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll definitely look. So you can have one too.
Yeah, because it's harder.
Harder without it.
But the way I do it is like, so, you know the stand, like, use the iPad, there's a stand up right here. I don't put it up like this to make it show the screen like this. I make it like...
landscape? So it's wide? Not like this, but like this?
No, kind of. I make the standing go like this.
Mm-hmm.
So now I do that.
Oh, that's smart. So it's kind of like at an angle.
Yeah.
Oh, that's smart.
It's a little.
Does Nash's keyboard, does it connect to the iPad?
Yes.
It has like a port thing that you stick it in?
No, it's wireless.
Oh, it connects wireless.
Yes.
Okay. Good to know.
And every time he every time he turns the keyboard on, it just connects.
Okay, good to know. So they were writing stories in class, and now they're practicing typing their stories on the iPad. And it's so funny. I was telling him how I learned to type with Mavis Beacon. Do y'all remember Mavis Beacon? Like, I'm dating myself, because if you have no idea who she is, then that means I'm way older than you. But I had the Mavis Beacon program at home. My mom had it. We had it on our computer at home. So I would use it all the time. Like, I'm a pretty fast typer.
Yes, you are super fast.
I am super fast at typing.
You are the fastest in our family.
Because I used to play on Mavis Beacon, like, constantly. It was like a game to me. It was so fun. So I enjoy typing. I type pretty fast. But yeah, so we're hanging out here outside of Gracie's doctor's appointment, which happened to be right next to the hospital. Because Siege obviously can't go back in the hospital and babe is still there. We're waiting to hear. Well, we did talk to the cardiologist and everything looked good, but he still wants to get a CT scan on Chad's heart.
Okay,
and they're not sure if he's gonna get in today.
I can explain.
Okay, well, you wanna explain the CT?
If nobody knows what a CT is, it's
CT scan.
It's basically like it like scans your heart, and it's like an X-ray, but it scans your heart.
Very good.
And it scans, doesn't look.
Very good.
And nobody knows what CT stands
for. Yeah, I was like, I don't really know what CT stands for. And I don't even think I've ever had a CT scan. So I feel like that's how it goes. So yeah, he wants to get that. And we're waiting to see if radiology can get him in today, because they are like slammed. And yeah. So he said if he can't get him in today, since we are so close, he may just let him come home and just, you know, like rest and then come back once they can get him in. But we may be able to go to like a different location, like the different hospital locations around the city, because they may be able to get him in quicker. So I don't know. We're still waiting. So yeah, I'm gonna drop Siege off to mom and go back and hang out with babe until it's time for me to pick up Ray.
Why don't you call her?
I think she just texted and said that they just finished. Yep, she's finishing up.
Okay.
Hey, what's up, Pete?
What up?
Happy Taco Tuesday testimony. Terrific Tuesday.
Y'all so funny. It's hot out here.
It is like a furnace.
It is like 90 degrees today.
We walked out of the building and it was like,
it's like hit you, right?
Yeah,
it's crazy.
Yeah, so.
Oh, Lord.
That's
come on now, Siege. What you doing?
I don't know.
So where do you want, what y'all gonna do?
I'm gonna take it with me and then we'll go back to your house.
Okay.
If that's okay.
Oh, okay. Well, you could just go back to the house now.
Huh?
Well, I guess y'all don't need me to go for y'all to get in.
Hey, gorgeous.
Daddy.
Hey, buddy. How are you?
He's back home.
How are you?
Good. Hi, baby.
How good are you feeling?
I feel pretty good. I'm just tired.
You feel better.
Yeah, I do.
Oh, he's so excited.
I'm so glad to see you again.
Oh.
You
oh, okay, Siege, with the headstand.
I'm a
megalodon.
Exactly.
Test tomorrow will be good. All good.
It's already done.
Already done.
Jesus' name, it's already done.
Yes, so did I tell you that the stress test and the echo were good? I think I told you this in the car. So he's gonna have his CT tomorrow at a different hospital. So they discharged him. So yay! And those numbers were good, so
they've got better.
It's time for Taco Tuesday. Chad, don't let her write on all of your homework paper. Reagan, that's Chad's homework paper. She done made a whole, let me see it. She done made a whole masterpiece on this. You want some more paper? Here, I'll get you some printer paper. How you feeling, Chad?
Good.
It's the next day.
It's the next day.
Babe had his CT scan today.
Mm-hmm.
And,
Daddy, could I have some? Could you
tires?
Put the straw inside this juice?
Okay, baby, you got it. Turn it over.
Yeah, I realized we didn't come back after he got home yesterday. So I just wanted to give y'all an update. Even though, like, we still gotta wait on, like, the CT scan results.
Yeah.
But have you been feeling today?
I've been feeling good today. Good job, boy. Thank you.
Oh, a charger.
Guess
nice.
Where I found it.
Where?
Yes.
Where did you in your it? Room?
Nope.
In my room?
Yes.
Oh, of course you did. He's the king of stealing chargers.
Yeah. So, yeah, yes! I felt pretty good. I feel pretty good. I have a headache still because of the
CT scan?
The pill that they, the nitroglyceride and the other pill that I had to take for the CT scan. Mm-hmm. So, I have a headache. I'm just tired, but,
yeah.
So, hopefully, in a couple days, prayerfully, we'll get it all clear, and then I can get back to training. Because I can't train until
he's on house arrest right now.
Yeah.
Via me and the doctor.
She wouldn't even let me. She wouldn't even. she arranged for mama to come over here. I was like, why is mama here again?
Because I had my kickoff call with my Fix My Eats crew, and I was like, I don't know what these kids gonna be doing. So I, mom came over to make sure because I didn't know how you were gonna be feeling after
your
CT scan.
I was like, why is she here?
Because I forgot to tell
him. She's like, because your wife recruited me to come watch the kids. So I appreciate you. You're awesome.
Yes, I took him to a CT scan. Okay, told him to sit his tail down. Just sit down and enjoy the week off of training. Enjoy the rest.
It's hard.
Don't worry about the time missed. You're fine.
It's hard.
You're alive. That's what matters, okay? So, yeah. Just wanted to give y'all that quick little update. And, yeah.
Yes.
That's it.
All my peeps in the place with a smile on their face. You know we keeping it real, but it's all heart-shaped love.